Good day from ChemHelp ASAP. Ethers are extremely stable functional groups, but they certainly are not inert. Let's see how these functional groups can be forced to react. We have two reactions on the screen that result in the breaking of a CO bond and therefore destroy the ether functional group. Both involve strong acids, and the first step is to protonate the ether oxygen with our acid. The result of this step is to make a leaving group on our ether. What happens to that leaving group differentiates the two pathways. In the top pathway, we have, in the middle, our protonated ether. The counterion may act as a good nucleophile and cleave the CO bond through an SN2 reaction. This pathway only works if the carbon has a lower degree of substitution. Higher substitution leads to higher sterics, and the SN2 will not occur. The bottom pathway shows, in the middle, a protonated ether. It's possible that our leaving group might leave to form a carbocation and our alkyl. The counterion might attack the carbocation, and then we would have broken the CO bond through an SN1 pathway. This pathway only works if the carbon has a higher degree of substitution in order to form a more highly substituted, stable carbocation. Those are our two options. Let's see some reagents and try to make some general predictions on how each will react with different ethers. On the left, we have several reagents that are often used to cleave the CO bond of an ether to form an alkyl and an alkyl halide. Some of these are Bronsted acids, donate a proton, and others are Lewis acids, coordinate to the oxygen. For our purposes, we can simply think of these as acids, and we'll really focus on the halide counterion. I'll call out one reagent. In the upper left, TMS-I iodide stands for trimethylsilyl iodide, or iodotrimethylsilane. One last comment. To minimize confusion, when I talk about the degree of substitution, I'll refer to the degree of substitution of the alkyl halide product of the reaction. The table says it all. Notice that these reagents can be easily divided based on the halide counterion. HCl, because chloride is not a good nucleophile, can only operate through an SN1 mechanism. It's limited to the cleavage of tertiary ethers, maybe secondary if you heat the reaction. We get a no reaction for methyl and primary. All the other reagents with bromide and iodide can do either an SN2 or SN1. Less hindered systems go through an SN2 with these good nucleophiles, bromide and iodide. More hindered systems, like tertiary, go through SN1. The secondary systems could be arguably either SN2 or SN1. I haven't addressed the alkyl product, but alkyl alcohols can continue to react with these acids. So this alkyl may continue to react. I'm just focusing on the ether. So ethers certainly resist reaction, but in the presence of strong acids, the oxygen is protonated. Once you make a leaving group, you're then set up for an SN2 or SN1 reaction to break the CO bond.